And welcome, everybody. You're listening to WWPT 90.3 FM. My name is Devin Jarvis, joined here by Cody Goldman, and we're here at Danbury High School for an FCS basketball matchup. As we have the starting lineups coming out right now, tell me about these teams and what they've done so far this season.
To start it off with the Danbury Hatters, a solid 8-0 overall record with big wins against Ridgefield, New Canaan in overtime, and Trumbull. On the other hand, Staples, a 7-0 start to the season with big wins against Newtown, Ridgefield, New Canaan in overtime, and Greenwich.
You're coming off the big win against Greenwich, 18 points away, that is. And talk about the impact first-year coach Goldshore has had so far this season. They're 7-0, the best start they've had in a good while. Talk about him for a moment.
Absolutely. Coach Dave Goldshore, first season as the head coach, he has completely restructured the program. Varsity development team now instead of a JV team, and they practice with the varsity team but do not play on varsity. They only have eight players, so I think that is huge for them, those young players practicing with them. On the other hand, head coach Casey Bach for the Danbury Hatters, his 14th season as the Danbury head coach, and this is their best start since 2015, and he has just done a phenomenal job this year.
Absolutely. I mean, he has a 55% career win percentage. He started off a little slow, but then picked it up in the mid-2000s, going into late-2000s, had multiple 15-win seasons, and now he's right back at it as he slowed down before, but he's good to be back. And, you know, these two teams, Staples going into it as the 11th-ranked team in the state, Danbury as the 5th-ranked team in the state, we're going to be some keys for both of these teams if they want to come out on top.
To start off with Staples, getting off to an early lead is a huge key for them, as Danbury plays like the best team in the state when they're ahead, but does tend to struggle to play as a team when they get behind.
Absolutely. I mean, if they can get ahead early, they might throw a wrench in this whole plan that Danbury has. I mean, they haven't been behind in most of any of their games at all so far this season. I mean, an 8-0 record. You can tell about that by just looking at the score sheet.
Yeah, I mean, not seeing that to start the season, maybe Staples doing that can get them off track. But on the other hand, Danbury, the big key for them, containing the big center, Chris Zajac. They do have almost three kids, 6'5", on the floor at any time, so they need to make it their job to limit his production.
That's exactly right. And we're almost underway here to get the tip-off going. It's going to be Zajac and Quentin Chapman for Danbury. Here we go. And no one wins it yet. It's going to be Sale picking it up, though. The deep right wing, he holds it. Guarded closely by Chapman, swinging it out all the way to Honig now in the quarter before it was Rothenberg. In the paint, it's Zajac. Left post now, getting it to Kukier. Down low, blocked on the way up by Sham Perkins. He rebounds that block, though. It's Rothenberg at the top of the key. Now Honig on the left. Left wing, he has it, getting it to Zajac down low on that post. He goes down in the paint, one dribble, lifts it up. Blocked, no good. Rebound by Danbury, going down the left side now. It's Kashawn Perkins who holds it. Now Cam Perkins in the corner, Sham. Sham carded closely by Rothenberg to Cam in the corner. Near corner, Cam has it, rotating out to the wing. Hands it off to Sham. Sham holding it out, driving down to the baseline. Holds it left post, back up top. That's Jeffers, has it go now at the elbow. He's in the paint, swinging it out down low. Can't get anything yet, and for three, it's Perkins, no good. Rebound off the side iron. Cam Perkins with the rebound, no good. And now Staples has it.
Great defensive start for both teams. Danbury, we saw, they did a great job containing Chris Zajac in the paint, and Staples defense did a great job moving their feet on defense and getting Danbury to miss those shots.
It's Zajac now with the high post on the right side, but he gets it to Cody Sale up top before a timeout is called by Coach Dave Goldshore. 6:37 now in the first quarter, and it's still 0-0.
Early timeout for Coach Dave Goldshore. Wonder if something is wrong with what they wanted to start with. He does look a bit angry in the huddle right now, but like I said, great defensive start for both teams early on in this game.
And oftentimes, you almost expect players like Chris Zajac to just find their rhythm right away. Missed a shot there, but no doubt he'll come back, as he always does. I mean, he's averaging nearly 18 points a game right now. That's the most on the Staples roster, followed closely second by Cody Sale with 14 of his own. But it's going to be Staples inbounding now. It's Charlie Honig. He has Kukier on his left, but he's going to hold it now. Can't find anything yet. Chris Zajac going to get in the corner. Swinging it out to Kukier up top on the right wing. He holds it. Picked up his dribble. Now Sale. He's at the deep wing. Go back to Swetner. Swing it around to Honig. Honig to Kukier in the paint. He holds it. Back to Honig up top for three. Off the back out. Off the back iron and rattles out before Danbury gets the rebound. It's Kashawn Perkins who gets it to Jeffers. Jeffers on the right wing. He holds it. And gonna back off to Kashawn, getting it to Sham up top. Sham holds it. A pick by Jeffers as he drives to the baseline to lift up a two. That's no good. Rebound. And going the other way is Zajac. Zajac all the way to the paint. Knocks a man over, but he doesn't get the two in. The layup no good, and Cam Perkins with the rebound.
Although Zajac did miss that layup, that was a good look from him. Looking to see more of those takes to the rim as this game goes on.
And Cam Perkins drives down the lane now for two and fouled on the way up. First points of the game.
Finally, we see some points, and that was a fantastic drive by Cam Perkins, one of the three Perkins brothers to start off the scoring in this game.
And there it is. Some say he might be one of the most well-rounded players in the entire state. And we've seen the work he's done in the paint right now. He's had a couple of opportunities, but this is the first one he's made. His first free throw of the game here. And he knocks this one down. Staples down 3-0 to the Hatters. It's going to be Honig taking it up. He holds it at the deep right wing, guarded closely by Sham Perkins. Good defense from him. Getting it to Kukier on the right. Rothenberg in the corner. Now down to Zajac at the right post. He holds it looking for a man up top. That's Rothenberg. Now on the left wing, Sale driving in the lane. A stop-up jumper just rattles out once again. So close for Sale there. On the other way, it's Sham Perkins driving in the low post and out of the corner. And a man down low, that's Chapman. Back up to Perkins up top. That's Kashawn. Kashawn to Cam. Cam guarded closely by Zajac. The left wing. He loses dribble for a second there. Zajac almost gets it. Yes, he does. Now on the left side, driving into the paint. 1-2, get knocked over, but he's called for a charge.
Zajac, great defensive play, although he did get the charge there. Once again, like I said, driving to the basket will be a big part of this game for Staples, for Chris Zajac, but both times coming up empty. Maybe a little out of control there as he fell to the floor, and they will take him out.
I mean, when we look at the amount of points these teams have scored in their previous games, this is definitely uncharacteristic. So only 3 points for the two teams in the first 3 minutes of the entire game.
Absolutely. You got to give the credit to the defense, though. They've done a great job moving their feet and communicating on the defensive end. But definitely look like the offenses are a little out of hand to start it off.
Sham holds it as Clacco subbed in to guard him. And a good nearly steal there as he knocks the ball out of Sham's possession. And once he does again, he can't hold on to it. And a great steal by Clacco. Now going the other way is Kukier from a pass from Smith. And that's and one for the three-point play coming up.
Wow, what a great defensive play from Sam Clacco. You love to see that. As normally you do not think of him as a big defensive player, more of a sharpshooter and more of an offensive player for the Wreckers, but great hustle from him there. You love to see him diving on the floor.
No doubt. He's a smaller guy, so he has to use the technique as much as he can on his defensive side of things. As Kukier ties it up with the free throw there. What an execution from that, from the Wreckers there. On the other way, it's Sham going all the way down looking for Cam in the middle. Tipped up by Sale, but on the way up, he gets fouled in the paint. And that's another basket for him as he has five on the board already.
Yeah, that was a mismatch right there, taken advantage of by the Danbury Hatters. Cam Perkins on Adam Udell in the paint. Cam Perkins is going to win that most of the time.
Now he's here for a free throw. And he gets it. Now 6-3 with 4:27 to go here in the first quarter. Kukier on the inbound to Udell, going down the right side, guarded closely by Kashawn. Pass midcourt, right wing. Holding it, handing off to Clacko in the corner, swinging it around, top of the key, to Kosale on the left now. He holds it, going back toward the middle, looking for Smith, but gets past him. Kukier recovers, Clacko on the left wing now. He holds it, Smith on the right, going down the lane, trying to split some defenders, and fouled on the way up in another three-point play opportunity for the Wreckers.
Incredible, that is the fourth three-point play we have seen to start off this game. All the scoring so far, if Caleb Smith can hit this free throw, but you love to see that from Caleb Smith, as he is really the heart and soul of this team. Very tough guy, quarterback for the football team, but a great take right there.
And he gets it, no doubt, as he ties it up at six with four to go here in the first. Kashawn Perkins taking it up for the Hatters now. That's Udell trying to force him to his left, as that's been their defensive strategy so often throughout this season. And a quick foul there as Udell gets charged for his first.
Absolutely, but that defensive strategy for the Wreckers, making them go left to their offhand, is going to be huge in this game, as I believe all of if not most of their players are righties.
Yeah, but there is one lefty for the Hatters. That's Shemez Perkins, who might be the best player on their entire team, as he gets the ball on the right wing now. Holloman on the defense. A pick from Jeffers as it's Sham going into the paint from the elbow. He lifts that one up. No good. Rebound Holloman. Going the other way now is Sale. He holds it. Quick pass to Holloman. And that's he tries to find Clacko in the middle for the layup. But it doesn't go. Rebound by Kukier. Clacko in the left corner for three. Good! And the Wreckers are up by three.
You know, a good break there from the Wreckers as Clacko couldn't hold on to that pass, but Clacko, the sharpshooter, no doubt right there, wide open in the corner.
And what a move by Sham to drive down into the paint for two. And now they're down by one with three here to go in the first. A great move from Perkins. Sale hands it off to Smith now. He has it on the right wing, trying to drive toward the middle, create space for Sale for three, and that's good. A deep one from Sale to push it to 12.
Cody Sale, we've seen that a lot from him. That deep shot, it's gone a lot for him as well. Great job to start it off from him, to start him off with the points.
Jeffers hands it off to Shemez at the top. He's driving down the lane, creates space with Smith as he gets fouled on the way up.
You know, something I've noticed early on, these Danbury Hatters are very chippy, and they like to talk. Sham Perkins, I saw him chirping up Sam Clacko, and Sam Clacko being able to keep his poise is going to be huge for the Wreckers.
No doubt, as this will be Sham's first free throw. That's good. That'll make it his third point of the game.
Big part of basketball, getting in the head, and Danbury likes to try to do that to all of their opponents, and Staples keeping their poise is going to be huge.
And here he is for his second as he misses it left, and a rebound by Kukier. Slowing it down is Sale as he crosses midcourt now, hanging around the right wing, looking for a play. Nearly stolen by Shemez as Honig gets it to Clacko now in the corner. Sale once in the corner once again. He's guarded closely by Leroy, knocks him over, but no foul called, looking for Smith in the paint. Stolen by Jeffers, going the other way is Leroy. Leroy has it at the left wing. Tries to drive down the middle, backs up, holds it now to Sham. Sham guarded by Honig. This is a matchup we were expecting to see going into this match. As he drives in the paint, kicks it out to Jeffers. Jeffers now from the corner drives in as he gets the ball knocked out of his hands. It's going to be Hatter's ball on their side of the court.
Early on for the Wreckers, you know, we've seen it's been back and forth their offense. Been a little bit sloppy, but once again, they have picked it up a little bit on the second half of this first half.
Sean Perkins kicking it out to Florida up top. Now it's Jeffers. Jeffers at the top of the key, guarded by Smith. Smith now to Kashawn in the corner now. That's Shirail. Shirail to Leroy in the corner. Left wing now, Kashawn. Kashawn looking for a teammate on the right side, Shirail, but he saves it before it goes out of bounds. Jeffers now to Kashawn up top, driving in the paint, has space from Clacko's missed defense, and he lays it in for an acrobatic layup there to cut the lead to just 1 point with 1:30 here to go in the first.
We've seen that a lot, especially Danbury driving to the hoop. That is their specialty, and they've got a lot of athletic players that can make athletic shots.
It's Honig now on the right wing as he tries to reset for the Wreckers. Fakes a shot, looks for Clacko on the left. Open three, that's good.
Clacko's second three of the game, same spot. They just cannot leave him open. He is going to knock that down almost.
As Felito drives into the baseline, he kicks it out to Jeffers, but he's charged for a foul there, a charging foul. That'll be his first of the game.
Like I said, Clacco off to a great start for the Wreckers. 6 points already, 2 for 2 from three. Like I said earlier as well, Sham Perkins was getting in his face a little bit, and he's looking like he's silenced him to start off this game.
Two big shots from Clacco, and like we said, the guards need to make plays if Staples wants to come out on top here. Under a minute to go here in the first. It's Sale who holds it at the top of the key, guarded by Leroy. A quick pass to Honig, now back up to Kukier. Same spot. Now Sale on the left wing. To the right wing now, it's Honig. They're holding the ball, trying to waste some time here. Kukier, left wing, guarded closely by Shirail. Looking for Honig in the middle, but the pass is deflected. And on the other way, it's Jeffers fast. He holds it at the top of the paint. And that's a quick shot there from Jake Florida, and it's three to pull the game within one with under 30 seconds now to go. On the other way, it's Sale. He tries to hold the ball close, driving into the paint. An acrobatic layup rattles in, and they're up by three now. Kashan going the other way, right wing guarded by Honig. Quick two dribbles to Shirail. Shirail guarded by Kukier. And a deep three from Kashan off the back iron. Rebound Jeffers on the right post. He drives in the paint and puts it up for two. And that is the quarter.
Fast start to that, the end of that quarter. A quick first quarter, but we started off Staples with a 1-point lead, 17-16. It has been back and forth, as it was a slow start to start off the game, but teams picked it up at the end of that first quarter. And something I've noticed, both these teams, they like to take it to the rack. And other than Sam Clacco hitting those two threes, there have been as well as Cody Sale hitting that three, there have been a lot of takes to the basket, and that has been huge for the Danbury Hatters as well, especially.
And a big quarter here. I mean, if we went into this game, Staples up by one after the first quarter, I'd say they're pretty happy with that. I mean,
absolutely.
Danbury, such a strong team. We've seen the performances they've had throughout the entire season. And we'll see what adjustments Coach Goldshore and Bach can come out with.
And, you know, we mentioned earlier one of the keys to the game for Staples was getting off to a fast start. And I think they have gotten up to a pretty quick start.
They started a little slow.
You know, they started a little slow.
But they got
but,
there.
You
and
know, so did Danbury. So it's been pretty even so far for both these teams. But I do think those threes for the Wreckers have been the difference in this first quarter. It's just 1-3 for the Hatters thus far.
I mean, if I were to tell you that Staples had 17 points in the quarter and none of them were from Chris Ajak, you wouldn't believe me. And now it's Jeffers at the top of the key for Danbury. On the right side, Kashan now. Gets the pick from Jeffers, driving toward the center. Rothenberg still in the defense, kicks it back out to Leroy. Leroy drives to the paint. Jeffers on the right side now. Jeffers holds it, resetting, right wing, back to the top of the key. Smith on the defense. Switching the ways, it's Shirail. And now it's Florida. Florida to Jeffers in the corner. Driving down the baseline, looking for a man up top, Shirail. He gets knocked down, but lifts up the jumper for two. And that's Shirail with the big shot there.
Interesting, we see Zajac has been out of the game for some time now. Coach Goldshore looked frustrated with him early in that first quarter, but Staples going with the small man lineup as Smith gets fouled by the free throw line.
That will be Danbury's fourth of this quarter. Staples has five, so they're edging closer to that bonus. And it's Sale who holds it. Shirail on the defense, gives it to Clacco on the left wing, looking for Smith down low in the paint. Off the side of the rim, and it's a rebound by Jeffers. Nearly falls in there with seven to go here in the second quarter. Florida now holds it on the right side. He's going to hand it off to Kashan. Two men on defense, and he drives into the paint now, has space, and a big block by Mason Tobias, the freshman.
You know, Mason Tobias, he doesn't get very many minutes, and for him to make a play like that, that is huge for the Wreckers. Mason Tobias, a freshman, stepping up for the Wreckers.
I'm surprised to see him so early in this game. I hesitated for a second there to see if it was for sure him.
Yeah, I mean, but,
I mean, this is a completely different approach from what we've seen in most games from Coach Goldshore.
It is interesting. Coach Goldshore, the mid-game adjustments, and seeing if that will pay off for him.
And it's Cam Perkins in the paint who gets the ball tripped up by Kukier. And As Rothenberg recovers, he goes the other way, and it's fouled by Cam Perkins.
We'll see right now. I mean, I don't know how long Chris Zajac will stay on that bench. Do you know if he's in foul trouble or anything?
He's not in foul trouble. I believe maybe he only has won the entire game from that first charge that he had.
Very interesting.
But, no, a completely different approach. Did not expect this at all. And it's Rothenberg who has it on the right wing, top of the key now. Flacco nearly got it, taken away from him, but he's driving into the paint, looking for Tobias down low, but blocked by Leroy on the way up. So it'll be Staples' ball, but a good heads-up play by Leroy, and a kind of a no-look pass
Absolutely.
From Flacco on the way there.
That was a clean pass from Flacco, and it looked like a good look for Tobias, but Leroy just came out of nowhere with that acrobatic block.
Flacco in the corner has it now, driving into the paint, looking for room. Oh, nearly gets it as he extends his right arm. And it gets knocked out of bounds. It's going to go the other way.
Flacco, I think, you know, teams know he's a great shooter, so he tries to take advantage of that and use that head fake, but Danbury did not get fooled there.
Leroy kicking it out to Sham at the right wing. He holds it, looking for a man. Stolen by Sale. Fast break the other way. Can he get it? Yes, he can. No. Nearly goes in, but it's no good. Rebound by Sham. Sham has it at the right wing. 18-17. Rutgers are down by one with 5:50 to go here in the second quarter. Swinging it around to Sherrail on the left wing, guarded by Flacco. Now to Leroy on the right. Down low is Florida. He hits the baseline fadeaway. No good. Rebound Kukier. A press defense from the Hatters as Sale can't find any space. Going to get knocked out of bounds by Jeffers, and it'll be Staples' ball.
You know, we're seeing that press from the Hatters, and I believe that they do that press when maybe they're... And as Zajac is in the game for the Wreckers finally, but I believe they do that press when... You were saying this earlier, when they're maybe a little feeling a little poised.
Right, exactly. And when they get under pressure, they could start to crumble a little bit, but it seems like they've held strong so far. Zajac, for the first time in the ball in the wild, kicks it out to Rothenberg in the corner for three! And there it is. The Wreckers are up by two.
Great shot from Rothenberg there. Good pass as... goes out of bounds. It is Staples' ball. Another turnover for the Hatters.
Sham Perkins looking for a teammate in the corner. Nobody there, so it'll be out of bounds against him. And five here to go in the second quarter as we have Kukier, Udell, Zajac, Sale, and Rothenberg on the floor. And Sale hits the pass, hits him in the chest, but it's going to go right out of bounds as he can't secure it with his hands.
Uncharacteristic from Sale right there.
He's calling for a little bit of a foul there. Maybe.
Yeah.
Thought some Sherrail may have gotten involved, but it's going to be a timeout quickly by the Hatters. Coach Bach going to reset.
So Zajac now in the game. Interesting to see. Maybe Coach Goldshore got angry with him, wanted to sit him down, maybe teach him a little bit of a lesson, something like that,
well,
and see if he can come back in this game now.
What I think is he saw a lot of I don't think he got angry with him. It's hard to get angry with maybe the best player in the FCAC. But what I did see is I think they found out, okay, they have these big guys up down low, and a lot of times Staples doesn't have opponents who have 3-6-5 players. So he's struggling a little bit in the paint because he's never seen maybe this type of defense before, and maybe trying to involve those guards a little bit will help for Staples' production. But I think almost getting Zajac back in the game now will expand the opportunities for the guards, as he's going to draw so much attention from the forwards down low for the Hatters that he could increase the production of what we see from the guards.
Absolutely, and that's what we were expecting coming into this game. We knew the guards had to step up for the Wreckers with Zajac in there drawing the defense into the paint.
It's Kashawn for three from the left wing. Off the right iron, rebound Jeffers at the baseline. He's in the right post now, making space in the paint, guarded closely by Honig. Gets his own rebound after a missed shot, and that's for two. Tied up at 20 now, with under five to go. It's Zajac set to sub in now. Honig going down the right sideline, and he holds it. And stolen by Jeffers as he looks for Smith on the pass. Fast break. 1-2 step, lifts it up, no good. Rebound by Smith, going the other way now. Has a man in the corner for Sale. 3, no good. Off the back iron, rebound by Rothenberg underneath. Missed layup, and Staples will keep it as it gets knocked out of bounds.
Wow, back and forth action. Both teams scrapping for the boards there as Staples will come down with it, but number 10, Jeffers. Jeffers got to the hoop twice there, but maybe a little out of control on that second attempt on that fast break.
Klacko and Zajac back in the game as Zajac gets the inbound on the right wing, hands it off to Kukier. Kukier guarded closely by Chapman. Now it's Klacko on the left wing. A pick by Sale. Dishes it to Zajac, now to Rothenberg in the corner as he drives up the baseline for 2.
Love to see that from Gavin Rothenberg. Don't see it very often, actually, but he's a very athletic player, and him getting to the hoop with ease right there.
Trail has it on the left wing, going to kick it out to Jeffers at the top of the key. He holds it. A play being called by Staples coach Goldshore as Trail now gets it on the right wing, back up to Jeffers up top. Now on the left wing. It's Edward, who has some space, kicks it out to Kashan on the left corner. No good. Ball's a little too long. Now on the fast break, Cody Sale going all the way down, lifts up the layup. No good. Sam Klacko for the put back. No good once again. Rebound Sherrail. Now Kafour for 2 on the left elbow. No good. Rebound Zajac with 3:20 here to go in the half.
Finally slowing it down for the Wreckers. We saw some back and forth action there as the Hatters are pressing up near midcourt, but a lot of missed layups, a lot of missed shots, maybe a little out of control, both teams.
It's Sale driving to the driving in the lane, but he gets called for a foul gets called against him before anything can happen. Shot does not go. And the Wreckers up by 2 right now with 3 to go here in the half. A somewhat comfortable position from what they were expecting. It's going to be Sale on the inbound.
Absolutely. The Wreckers being up 2 right now, I think they're feeling very comfortable with that, especially with Zajac not playing very much in the first half as he gets fouled.
Zajac gets fouled after he gets the contested inbound pass, but that will put Danbury into the bonus, and Zajac going to the line for the 2-2. This could be his first points of the game.
Crazy we're saying that with 3 minutes left in the half, but that has really been the story of this game. Zajac not playing very much, as like you said earlier, Danbury caught on to that plan.
That first free throw, no good off the back iron. Rebound Leroy. On the left side is Kashan. He's on the left wing. Back to Jeffers up top. Driving into the lane, trying to look for a man down low. Chapman for 2.
Great look there from Jeffers up top. And just using his eyes to fool the defense. They never saw that man in the down below the basket.
And a pass to Zajac gets tripped up. Going the other way, it's Leroy holding it at the left wing. He's going to reset, has some space from the baseline, driving in the lane, looks for Chapman. Chapman guarded by 2-1 Zajac. And now reset with Jeffers in the right corner. Jeffers holds it. Ball gets knocked out by Klacko. Good defense so far from him this entire game. Sherrail to Leroy in the corner. Leroy at the left wing now, resetting with Kashan up top. He's guarded by Rothenberg with, as we get close to under 2 minutes here in the half. Loses his dribble for a second, but he has it now. Jeffers down low, under the baseline, going all the way around, but he gets the shot up, no good. Kukier with the rebound. It's Sale who has it on the left side now. We're all tied up as he drives toward the baseline, can't get the layup. Good defense by Jeffers, and now it's Leroy at the left wing, 1:45 to go here in the half.
Jeffers, yeah, great defense there. We see that drive from Cody Sale a lot and able to alter that shot.
Jeffers for 3 from the right wing, no good. Rebound once again by the Hatters, and Jeffers again. This one he gets to go as it rattles in and puts them up by 3.
Couldn't get it the first time, tried again, same exact spot, and got it. Big part of this game, that was a big offensive rebound for the Hatters right there.
Sale now driving down the lane, a backwards layup to put it in. And now the lead is just cut to 1 as we tick under a minute to go here in the first half. Chapman down the left side, pushes toward the elbow, kicks it out to Jeffers on the right corner. Same spot as he hit the last one, but this one won't fall. And Sale now taking it up for the Wreckers. gets it to Klacko. Klacko holds it, top of the key. Rothenberg on the right, Sale now in the right corner. He has Zajac in the post, but he's not going to hand it off. Zajac now in the right corner, fakes the shot. Picks up his dribble, goes down, fakes the down low. It's Sale on the right wing now. Leroy in the defense, picked from Zajac. And now it's Rothenberg in the left corner. Zajac down low, turnaround, jumper won't go, rattles out. Rebound Zajac. And he gets another shot up, no good. Zajac can't get it to go. And it's the Hatters going the other way. Kashawn Perkins at the top of the paint, holds it. Leroy on the right side for three. Oh, just barely rattles out. And now Sale with under 10 here. 5 seconds to go now. He's driving in the lane. A pick and a foul against the Hatters there. What could have been called a charge is nothing.
Sale once again driving to the basket. We've seen that a lot so far in this game. But Chris Zajac, wow. I cannot believe we're saying this. With 3.2 seconds to go in this half, still 0 points. Just couldn't get the ball to go on those. He had what looked like a ton of chances for a layup there, but couldn't get it to go.
And to tie it, Cody Sale puts that one in. And we're all square at 25 apiece. This one would put the Wreckers with the lead with just 3 seconds to go here in the half. That student section is loud from Danbury, but he gets that one up and good. And now the Wreckers lead going into halftime, unless Danbury can get a shot up before the clock ticks zero.
If you ask me, very ideal for the Wreckers.
It's Kashawn Perkins dishing up to Shirial. A deep three off the front iron, no good. And the Wreckers will be up 26-25 as we go into halftime. A solid half from them, but the big question remains, where has Chris Zajac been? I don't think he's found his groove quite yet. We could see that as we go into the second half. But if you can only see what Staples can do without Chris Zajac, imagine what they can do when he gets going.
Exactly what I was thinking. And to be up one to end this half is very ideal for the Wreckers, if you ask me. And Klacko has been huge for them, as well as Honig. And, you know, it's crazy to see what this team could do, even without Chris Zajac in this first half.
I mean, seriously, Udell, Honig, Sale, Rothenberg and Klacko have been so strong. Those five main guards for the Wreckers. I mean, even Tobias came in for a second. I mean,
got a huge block.
So, like, what we don't see from the Wreckers oftentimes, I mean, maybe it's just structured around their game plan, because their game plan is always Chris Zajac, Chris Zajac, Chris Zajac. You don't see the other guys get to perform. But we're really seeing strong performances from the guards right now. I would love to see Chris Zajac get involved in the second half, as obviously I want the Wreckers to win, but at the same time, it's definitely raising a question on what is going on with him.
Absolutely, and maybe another factor is obviously Danbury going into this game was expecting a lot of Chris Zajac, and not seeing him, maybe that changed it up for them, and maybe that's why the Wreckers have been so good in this first half, even without Chris Zajac.
And that'll do it for now, as we're going to send it off to the studio for just a moment, but you're listening to WWPT 90.3 FM. Charlie, why don't you take it away, and we'll be back in just a few.
I'm gonna go get my shit.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And welcome back, everybody. I'm Devin Jarvis, joined here by Cody Goldman. And we're here once again at Danbury High School for a battle of FCAC basketball. The Staples took the first half victory 26-25 as they're looking strong. A surprising effort from them, as they weren't the favorites going into this one, were they, Cody?
They were not, and we thought coming into this game, Chris Zajac, obviously the big part of this team, best player on the team, but we did not see much of him in that first half as Danbury caught on to the Wreckers' game plan early on, but the Wreckers still with their guard play have the lead going into this second half.
That they do. And it's going to be Honig kicking it off for the Wreckers on the left wing, getting Rothenberg in the corner. Now to Zajac on the right wing. Now to Honig in the corner as he drives up the baseline and fouled on the way up for a shot. He's going to go to the line for two here and have a chance to put the Wreckers up by three.
You don't see that much from Honig, the aggressive take there, but I do like that from Honig as he is more of a defense-first guy, big leader on this team, but good drive there, drawing the foul for the Wreckers. He will look to get his first points of the game.
And now he has an opportunity to advance this Wreckers lead past 26-25, but the first free throw is off the back iron. And he has another opportunity here. Cam Perkins back in the game for the Hatters. We saw him a little bit in that first quarter and second quarter, but not too much. This second free throw is good. No doubt there, as now Staples leads by two.
You know, we didn't see Cam Perkins that much, but he did make an impact while he was on the court. 6 points for the Hatters, giving them some good minutes.
It's Gashan finding Leroy in the left corner now. Now to Jeffers up top. Two steps in the paint, and he gets blocked by Zajac on the way up, but a rebound by Cam Perkins in for two, as we were just talking about him. There's his immediate impact. And going the other way, taking the ball up, it's Honig who's fouled by Leroy. And that's two fouls in the first 45 seconds here for the Hatters.
Yeah, and for the Hatters, Jeffers, we've seen a few of those drives to the basket, just looking a little out of control as he has missed them pretty badly, but Cam Perkins just right place, right time there.
And Sale gonna swing it around to Rothenberg in the left wing now. He's guarded by Leroy. Close is Zajac, driving down to the post, backing up to the left wing once again. And a pick from Zajac. At the top of the paint, pick and roll, Zajac gets it on the left post, doesn't get it to go, rebound Kukier once again, doesn't get it to go, but it's Honig who has it. Dishes it to Rothenberg at the top of the key, off the back iron, unfortunately.
Few missed chances there for the Wreckers. That was a pretty long possession, but a little bit sloppy as Zajac, once again, not a great shot, contested shot there, but looked like Kukier had a little more time to put up that putback, but maybe rushed it a little bit.
Zajac not able to find his rhythm quite yet. No doubt that it will come because he's been able to find it every single game so far.
It's just a matter of time.
Leroy going to get to Sham Perkins up at the top of the key. Swing it around to Jeffers. Now to Sean in the corner for three. That's good. And the Hatters take the lead by 3 points, 30-27 here. As a pass looks down low for Cam Perkins, but it's going to go out of bounds. Hatters are going to keep the ball here.
Great ball movement on that prior possession by the Hatters, finding Cusion Perkins wide open in the corner. Maybe some miscommunication for the Wreckers, as you do not want to leave him wide open.
Staples has possession here. It's Smith getting at the left wing, driving down the baseline in the left post now. Going to step back, get it to Sale up top. Deep left wing, and a call against Staples.
Looks like maybe Zajac with an offensive foul.
It could have been a three-point violation.
Oh, that might be
possibly.
It. Yep. But once again, Zajac maybe a little frustrated right now, just not in his groove. But like we said, it has to be coming at some point.
And now it's Sham Perkins going to give it to Kashan. Kashawn down to Cam. Back up to Kashawn for three. A deep one off the left wing. No good. Rebound Zajac. Going the other way is Sale up the left side. He is at the left wing. Cutting back to the center. Top of the paint. Hands it off to Smith. Smith going down the lane. Gets tripped up on the way there. And a bad dribble there. It's Jeffers going the other way. A spin move in the lane for two. And now it's the Hatters up by five.
Wow, what a move from Jeffers that I was just talking about, how he had some of those drives to the basket, maybe a little out of control, but looked completely in control there on that nice spin move.
Klacko finding his way to the paint there to Zajac, back up to Udell, back to Zajac in the paint, and there's his first points of the game, Zajac for two.
Maybe, we'll see, maybe if those first 2 points can get him going, giving him a little bit more of momentum.
Possibly a snowball for the Wreckers that is yet to build. Now Sham going into the paint, an acrobatic layup as he knocks Udell down. No good, rebound by Klacko. Guarded closely by Kashawn Perkins, but he's fouled before it goes out of bounds by Kashawn. So Wreckers will retain possession, and that's the third flat foul against the against the Hatters.
Sham Perkins coming into this game, maybe the Hatters' best player. Hasn't had his best game so far. Just 3 points, and we saw there that missed layup. Maybe a little out of control there.
Zajac getting in the post now, guarded by Cam Perkins as he lifts that one off the backboard. No good. Rebound Cam Perkins going the other way is Kashawn. Kashawn, speedy, at the elbow. Back up to Cam Perkins, takes the shot, and it's a double dribble before he makes his move. Going the other way now, the Wreckers have the possession.
Chris Zajac, once again, was not able to convert on the layups. Look like they're makeable layups, but just not falling for him. We've just seen those 2 points that we just saw, but interesting to see maybe if he can get going.
And a quick timeout from the Wreckers as Coach Goldschor is kind of going to reset. They went into this half up by one. They're down by three now. And I think we all know who the X Factor is for the Wreckers, and we'll see if they can get him active. You know, it's Chris Zajac.
Absolutely. Chris Zajac. Like we said, just those 2 points, and I'm looking to see maybe if they're gonna try to still if they're gonna try to get the ball into him as obviously he is their offense does run through him, so I'm looking to see if he can convert on those layups, and they gotta fall at some point, right? So either convert on those layups or draw the defense in and kick it out to those guards like Klacko for a three.
Udell now bringing it up, crossing midcourt on the left wing now. Looking for Sal on the left side, but Leroy gets in the way and knocks that one out of bounds on the left.
Another key player. We haven't seen much of Sal thus far in this first half. Maybe see if they can get him the ball.
Udell holding it on the left wing here, guarded by Perkins. Going down, has some space in the paint. Getting it to Zajac at the top elbow, and he's fouled on the way up. The shot will go, and he has two shots here.
Zajac getting to the line. Let's see if he can convert on these two layups, free throws. But Zajac, obviously the X factor for the Wreckers, and see if he can get these 2 points at the line. He's a great free throw shooter.
And he gets this first one to go. The Wreckers now pull it within 2 points. And here it is to just make it one with 4:30 here to go in the third quarter. Udell, Sale, Klacko, and Smith on the court. This one's going to go off the front iron, but it's a rebound by Smith. A quick shot there from the left wing from Sale, and he gets it to go. The Wreckers take the lead.
And there is Cody Sale. Right, like I said earlier, hadn't gotten the ball to him much in the half, but right as they get the ball to him, he drains a three.
Now Cam Perkins from the left wing. A redemption three, no good. Rebound Smith right by that baseline looking for a teammate. Finally gets Udell and a handoff to Sale. Going down the middle now, pushing toward the right side. He has it. Way back, top of the key. Now on the right wing, it's Klacko. Klacko holding it. Udell, right wing. Down to Zajac in the post. Udell off the pick and roll, and there it is for two.
There's Zajac. Maybe if he can't get the points up, the assist, drawing the defense in, and a great cut there from Udell.
Shirial to Jeffers in the right corner now as he holds it, guarded by Zajac. Going to find some space at the top of the paint here to Leroy. Leroy butts to Shirial on the right wing. Shirial holds it, and it's Jeffers on the left side. Jeffers back to Sham up top. Sham guarded by Udell to Cam Perkins in the left wing. Now it's Jeffers on the high post here against Smith. To Leroy up top, has some space in the paint. A floater off the back iron, rebound Zajac. Looks for Udell in the pass, but it falls between a couple legs. It's going to be Cody Sale who resets it and going to find Clacko in the corner, but on the way up, he gets the ball stolen. And it goes out of bounds before Leroy is able to control his momentum, and the Wreckers are going to get the ball on the left side here.
Yeah, Leroy sprinting around the court. Great hustle from him as Clacko was trying to get that shot up, but he did not allow it, and missing that, maybe a little frustrated for missing that floater before as he also almost stripped it away from Udell.
It's going to be Sale on the left wing now. Clacko in the middle. Has some space. Nobody in the paint. But the shot doesn't count. As he's fouled before he gets the shot up. So he'll go to the line. It'll be an inbound. But it's Danbury who's eking closer and closer to that bonus. As they're sitting at five fouls. The Staples haven't had a single one in this entire half.
That is very impressive for the Wreckers. You know, staying out of foul trouble is huge for them. As Clacko, we saw him use that leverage to his advantage, going to his strong hand, and a great drive there, drawing the foul.
On the left wing, it's Sale. He's trying to be forced to his left, but he's going to hold it. Smith in the corner now, and up and around, layup, no good. Rebound, Zajac foul on the way up in the paint. And he goes to the line for two.
And that's more of what you see from Chris Zajac. That 6'8 frame, getting the rebound easily. And
not only his ability to put those close ones in, but also he can draw so many fouls. He goes to the line for quite a few free throws. This is his fourth attempt this game.
Yeah, and he is a great free throw shooter. And maybe that speaks to the down game he's had, as he has missed two free throws thus far, but he did hit that one right there.
He sits at 4 points now, and his second one is good as it goes in, and the Wreckers take a commanding 5-point lead here with 2:41 to go in the third quarter. Leroy taking it up for the Hatters, guarded by Udell. He's trying to be forced to his left, and there he goes. Finds Florida in the corner. Going to pick up his dribble for a second, driving in the baseline, looking for Leroy down low. Backed up Shirai at the right wing. A pull-up jumper from the top of the paint off the left side of the rim. Rebound, Clacko.
Although Shirai couldn't get that shot to go, great ball movement from the Wreckers. Did get an open shot, and looking to from the Hatters, and looking to see that more from them.
Smith holds it at the right wing now, getting it to Zajac on the left wing, and now in the corner, it's Sale. Sale driving into the paint, has some space, and there he goes to put it in for two, and a timeout by Coach Bach as the Hatters are going to reset.
Just classic Cody Sale right there, getting to the hoop. That is just classic Cody Sale, and Wreckers now up seven, seeking momentum right now.
And Staples, what was once kind of a small crowd, has kind of arose a little bit. They now, as the Wreckers have a 7-point lead, it's Staples who comes out for the chance.
And definitely. And you love to see that from the fans. You know, the student section has been awesome this year. And it is midterm week for Staples, so you see the commitment from these fans.
And, right? I mean, let me tell you, I've been to a lot of the games so far in Canaan, Ridgefield, Greenwich one, and boy, do we travel. I feel like we've traveled more than we have ever in the past. And, I mean, I've asked some of the players on the court, that Greenwich game that we played, the impact that the student section had on their performance was more than they could put into words. And although, we're a 45-minute drive, maybe 50, depending on where you are in Westport, it's a little harder to get to this game, especially being midterms. A lot of kids at home studying.
Absolutely.
And but they've shown out.
And you think in that Greenwich game, you know, that huge rivalry, you know, maybe Greenwich a little angry from that football loss, you'd think they would have an impact on Staples in a negative way, but turns out Staples crowd has got an impact on a positive way for the Wreckers. That's just great to see for the Wreckers, as maybe it speaks to the kind of season the Wreckers are having.
As we wane out in the third quarter here, it's Leroy who takes it up the left side, getting it to Shirail in the corner, now Jeffers. Jeffers holds it on the right wing. Shirail now in the corner. Sale on the defense. He drives up, back up top. Rotates it to Jeffers in the corner. He's going to spot up for a three. Just a little bit too long, but a quick rebound by Kafour. Jeffers now, once again from the elbow, drives into the paint, and he's fouled on the way up. Two shots for him.
Jeffers once again getting to the hoop.
Looks like Coach Goldshore may be a little angry about that, but using that spin move once again and drawing the foul. The threes haven't gone for him, but he has gotten to the hoop a few times for the Hatters. As he shoots his first.
And he gets it. Now the lead at six with 1:38 here to go in the third quarter. Jeffers going up for his second now. And this one good as it rattles in. And Udell now taking it up for the Wreckers. 1:37 here to go in the quarter. He's going to slow it down. Just try and make this game as slow as possible. Don't waste as much time. A handoff to Sale in the left corner. He's going to try and get fouled. But it's a timeout before anything gets called. And Sale.
Absolutely.
On the left side there. And that's the second timeout so far this quarter. So they only have two left to go in the game.
Yeah, and that's a great use of the trap from the Hatters, you know, seeking the opportunity were they, as Sale was in the corner, so they used the sideline to their advantage there as kind of a third defender. And that's huge for the Wreckers. The timeouts are very big, especially in a game like this.
Especially when we get into those scenarios that just happened further in the game where they get trapped against that sideline.
Absolutely.
Staples are going to need that timeout, but obviously they don't want to get put in that situation. And even if they go down some points, they might need to reset.
Yeah.
And that's definitely not out of the question. I mean, Staples has done what they needed to do. They got to that lead, and they're at that point right now where when they get to that lead, it's Danbury's a little struggle. They struggle to come back from it. And they've held this for the remainder, or for the duration of this third quarter, and they just need to do it for another 9.5 minutes.
Absolutely, and both these teams have been in games like this. Both teams have been in overtime, so maybe looking to see that if that plays a role as we edge close to the end of this third quarter.
And what many consider the best opponent Staples has faced all season, they're up by 5.
Yeah, they're definitely handling it well.
Zajac only 4 points throughout the game here, but he's finding his rhythm a little bit here in the second half. Udell has it at the top of the key now. Going to swing it to the left post. Find Smith in the middle. Out to Sale for three. And a whistle is blown before the shot. And a foul is called. The crowd's not liking
fans
this.
Fans do not like that. It is very loud in here. As it looked like the official on the opposite side of the court called a foul. Maybe that's what they're mad about, but great ball movement from the Wreckers. Adam Udell finding Caleb Smith a dime, and Caleb Smith, great pass out to Sale.
And we'll see what the call is here, because we're not certain on whether or not it's a 1-1 or whether Sale's going to the line for three shots.
Refs talking it over, maybe a little bit of confusion here.
And it's funny because you don't often see the refs discussing what type of foul. It's usually in the NFL.
Yeah,
or,
exactly.
Or football, you see that, rather. So Coach Goldshore getting talked to by one of the referees here so he can understand what exactly went down.
Yeah, you don't see that very often. You know, the ref at near midcourt, you see Sale over by the corner, the opposite side, and he called a foul. I'm not sure if it was an off-ball foul or a shooting foul.
So we'll see what it is.
They are in the bonus, though, so.
And it's a 1-1.
Okay.
So Sale's going to have two shots here if he makes that first one. And they sit at 39 right now. The stadium roaring to try and contest Sale on this free throw.
And Staples is used to this, though. They're used to being in big games like this with the crowd very loud.
And that first shot is good. Knocked down, ice in his veins.
Exactly. Sale does not get fazed from the crowd. He is one of the most clutch players, maybe in the whole entire state for the Wreckers. As he gets that second one to go.
Bouncing off the front rim. He hasn't missed a free throw tonight. Shrail now taking it up the left side. He holds it at the top of the key now. Kafour rotating top of the key. Shrail on the left wing. Guarded by Klacko. Rotating around. He has it on the right post now. Fakes a shot. Gets it back up again, though, off the left side. Rebound Zajac. And he takes it up. Nobody in his way. Under a minute to go here in the third. It's Smith who holds it. Back down low to Zajac. Foul on the way up and one!
The crowd is roaring here as Chris Zajac gets his sixth point of the game. That's more what you were expecting to see from Chris Zajac, as the Wreckers are feeling it right now.
And a shot here can put the Wreckers up double digits. By far the biggest lead we've seen this night. And that he does! Timeout! Excuse me, no timeout, but the buzzer sounded, so substitutions came in for Danbury, and now 52 here to go in the third quarter.
And the Wreckers, I mean, looking like a big run they've gone on right now. Hatters have not scored in a long time.
Cam Perkins has it at the top of the key. He's backing way up, just wasting this clock out. You'd think they want to score as many points as possible. They're going to try and contest him, though. Coach Goldshore, tell him to push. It's Leroy in the corner open. He's going to drive through the center. Jeffers now on the left wing. He has some room in the paint. Goes up, and a good shot from him to put it in. Wreckers up by eight now. Udell going down the left side. Dishes it to Zajac as it's knocked out of bounds by Florida.
And maybe we'll see if that shot can give the Hatters some momentum, as once again we see Jeffers with that take to the basket, acrobatic take, getting it done, the Hatters.
It's Sale who has it at the top of the key. Sherrell on the defense. He's just holding it as we tick under 10 seconds to go in the third quarter. Defense, crowd, chance from the crowd. Sale going up the middle in the right post, hands it off to Smith. Under 4 seconds, Clacco now on the left wing. He's going to have to put this one up off the side of the rim. No good as we head into the fourth quarter.
Wow, what a great quarter for the Wreckers. Up eight, if you ask me, that's an incredible job from the Wreckers. Up eight going into the fourth quarter at Danbury. The Danbury crowd is extremely loud, as this is a huge game. And Wreckers, now they got to just maintain this lead going into this fourth quarter.
I mean, talk about a huge crowd. Danbury alone has more than 3,000 kids at their school. That's nearly double the size that Staples has. Nearly double. So as you can possibly imagine, this gym is packed as much as it could be.
Absolutely. And they are, I tell you what, they're making a lot of noise. But Wreckers, they're used to it, like I said. And they don't get fazed by that normally. So the crowd definitely going to play a big role in this fourth quarter.
And faces here from social media outlets throughout the state. Pete Paguaga from Game Time CT. QN Productions from his awesome Instagram page, and many others.
Absolutely. And Chris Zajac. We've seen him get going a little bit for the Wreckers, as he has 6 points now just in that third quarter. So maybe looking for him, obviously, to play a big role in this fourth.
And now,
excuse me, 7 points for Zajac.
And now Zajac is going to hang down that baseline, and Staples is going to have the inbound here to start the quarter. They make their move. It's Udell who gets it in the backcourt. Guarded closely by Sham as he finds the pass to Sale on the left wing. Down low, Zajac. Fixed the shot, goes back up, and gets it in for two for his ninth of the game.
Now, there, sorry. There is Chris Zajac, though, as I was saying. That's more of what you see from him as Perkins misses the layup.
And now going the other way is Clacco up the left side. Sale on the left wing, driving into the paint, looking for a man. Hands it off to Zajac, going up. Loses the ball. Clacco in the left corner. Fakes the shot, but he gets travel call before he goes down to the baseline.
Unfortunate call there for the Wreckers, as Clacco looking like he was trying to get a shot up, but just couldn't keep his feet. But like I said, like I was saying, Chris Zajac is going to be huge in this fourth quarter.
It's Chapman. He drives towards the baseline, kicks it out to Shaz up top, or Sham up top. He's going down the lane. Once again, kicked out to his brother, Sham. Now it's Jeffers in the corner. Going down the middle. In the corner, it's Cam Perkins for three. That's good!
What a huge shot for the Danbury Hatters. They're now down seven.
looking to seek momentum and come climb back in this game.
Udell going down, loses his dribble. Sale picks it up, and he fakes the jab. A floater up from him gets blocked as he lifts that up in the post. He gets his own rebound, though, after the block. And he holds it here, guarded by Chapman. Now Jeffers kicks it out to Klacko, now to Udell. Klacko has it at the top of the key once again. Smith on the left wing. Looks for a pick. Goes down the left side, though. Opposite way of the pick. Going up, and it's all ball. As that's going to be a jump ball on the way up, and a big, big stop by Chapman.
Danbury looking like they are maybe seeking a little bit momentum right now. Cam Perkins making a big impact on this game. Hit the three. Right back at it with the huge block.
In the corner, it's Jeffers. Driving into the post now, has it in the paint, looking for Cam Perkins up top. Now left wing. He holds it. Jeffers in the left post, guarded by Smith. He's going to try and make his move here to get into the paint. As he does, spin move on the way up. Foul! He goes to the line for two.
Like I've been saying, you see that all so often, that little jab from Christian Jeffers, and it has been working all night long for him as he gets to the line once again.
It almost is like what we've missed from Chris Zajac so far, the way he's able to create space like that. Jeffers has been so good this game, and he has an opportunity to close this to a two-possession game, and that he does with that shot right there. 40-46 as the Wreckers have the lead with 6:13 here to go in the game.
Free throws are going to be huge for the Hatters down the stretch. Need to hit their free throws.
And the second one rattles out, rebound by Zajac. Sale, who holds it in his side of the court, gets it to Udell. Sham on the defense, going down the right side, fakes the cut, picks up his dribble. Sale on the left wing now. Sale holds it. Just wasting time here. You don't need to do anything if you have the lead. Now in the corner, it's Smith looking for Zajac in the middle of a bad pass. Stolen by Kashawn Perkins as he goes up for the layup. Udell not able to block it, and that goes in for two. The lead just 4 points, as it was once just 10 a few minutes ago.
Like you said, wasting time. Yes, they're going to want to do that, but they got to make sure they're not sloppy with the ball. And Zajac hits a three from the corner.
Well, if he's not as productive as he usually is from down low, might as well put him out to the arc as he gets that one. And now to respond, it's Chapman for three! And the lead, just 3 points.
Just traded threes right there. Chapman with a huge one for the Hatters. My goodness, as this crowd is very loud. Udell gets fouled. He's going to get 1-1 at the line.
But it looks like before that, the Zajac, what we thought was a three, is instead called a two. Coach Goldshore asking the ref about it now. And it gets called a two. He had his foot on the line.
And that's huge, as every single point obviously matters so much in this game going down the stretch.
Udell has an opportunity for two shots here. It's a 1-1. And Coach Bach calling out for the box outs here. He needs it. They need any point they can get. And the first shot from Udell off the back of the rim. Rebound Jeffers. Going the other way is Kashawn Perkins, guarded by Udell. Gets it to Jeffers on the right wing. Jeffers steps back for three. No good off the front iron. Rebound, but Chapman goes up. Fouled on the way up. And one for Danbury.
Oh my goodness, these fans almost breaking the stands. But Chapman has been huge as he hits 5 points in a row for the Hatters. And they can tie the game right now, as it seems like just a couple minutes ago they were down 10.
What a stretch play from the Hatters here. I mean, to get that offensive rebound, Chapman to put it back up for a potential three-point play. Here it is, to tie the game. That he does. We're all square at 48 with 5 here to go. Kukier is going to have it. Going down the left side, have some space. Kick it out to Klacko in the left corner. Back to Kukier in the paint. He goes up, blocked on the way up. Rebound Kukier. Klacko in the corner for three. Yes, he does. What a transition for the Wreckers to bounce back. Cham Perkins going down the baseline. An acrobatic layup, no good. Rebound by the Wreckers. Klacko finding Rothenberg open. He gets the layup blocked on the chase down. Jeffers going the other way. Jeffers has some space. One, two step, and he gets it to go. Danbury down by one with 4:22 here to go in the game.
My goodness, what a sequence of events there. Jeffers getting in the room again as
Rothenberg for three, no good off the front of the rim. Rebound by Jeffers. And an opportunity, Danbury here to take the lead. And Kashawn Perkins, as he drives down the lane, gets fouled by Rothenberg. No shots. And Staples not yet in the bonus, so it will just be an inbound.
And finally slowing it down, my goodness. That was an incredible sequence of events. But Placco, we saw, you cannot leave him open. And absolutely, Kashawn Perkins, Jeffers getting in the rim once again. We've seen that all night long.
It's Kashawn Perkins in the corner going down to find some space in the paint. And what a shot, fade away in the paint for two. And Danbury has the lead. Now Kukier going the other way. Zajac holds it on the right wing. Getting it to Sale. Sale at the top of the key. Guarded by two. Placco now left wing. Kukier open on the right wing. Back at the Sale up top. Fix the shot for three. Going to keep it. Has an open man. Zajac down low. As Placco holds it on the left wing. Going back to the top of the key. Now Rothenberg on the right. Sale in the corner. He fixed the shot. Have some space down low. He gets fouled on the way there, but it'll be against the Wreckers. And I'm surprised as you are watching this stream right now on what could possibly cause a foul there.
I think they might be saying that he stuck his elbow out, but I didn't see it. It just looked like he tripped. But a crucial call there as Danbury gets the ball back.
And Danbury now up by one with 3:20 here to go in the game. It's Kashawn Perkins guarded by Rothenberg on the left wing. He drives in the paint. Jeffers now in the left corner. Jeffers just going to hold it. He doesn't need to do anything. And Golcher here not going to call for a press yet. He's just going to keep that ball in the corner. And Golcher now telling Chris to step up, and that he does. Placco coming over for support. He finds some space. Goes for the corner as he gets tripped up in the paint. Looks for Cam Perkins in the corner, but the pass goes out of bounds. No foul call. And we're under 3 minutes to go here in the game.
Jeffers once again driving to the basket. That time, unfortunate though, couldn't keep his footing. We saw that with Sale earlier. Maybe a bit of an issue going into this game, the floor.
And Sale at midcourt now. He holds it, guarded by Chapman. A mismatch possibly. He finds some room in the paint. Goes up for two, blocked though. And a big one there. Going the other way is Kashawn Perkins in the paint. Lifting up the layup, and it's good. Danbury Hatters up by three. And a timeout by Dave Goldshore. A complete momentum shift from what we saw just 5 minutes ago.
And this crowd is really getting into it now. They're extremely loud. And on the other hand, the Staples student section is quiet. But my goodness, what an acrobatic play from Quinton Chapman, making that block and catching the ball.
And that's been the same thing a couple times where Chapman gets the big blocks and then in transition makes the play. And this time it was Kashawn Perkins who put that one in for two.
Like I was saying earlier, Staples, I mean, it's been crazy, but don't forget, going into this third quarter, Staples was up 10 points, but just an insane sequence of events, and the Hatters just took the lead just like that.
They're up 54-51 now with 2:35 here to go in the game. And the Wreckers are going to need to either get a three or two possessions here and hold Danbury away. And what a game it's been. Back and forth. We saw a strong performance from Danbury in the first part of that first quarter, and it's transition where Staples was able to take the lead by 1 point at halftime. And then Staples had the lead by 10 points at the end of the third quarter, and now we stand with the Wreckers down by three.
And it's just looked like Danbury has just completely shifted gears in this fourth quarter.
Udell taking it up for the Wreckers, guarded by Perkins. It's Placco in the right corner for three now, or to hold it. He loses the ball. Could be a jump ball here, but it's Cam Perkins who picks it up before anything. He's going in the middle. Jeffers now for two and an easy layup. Danbury up by five. Going the other way now. Udell holds it. Waddell has two men on him. Can't find any space. Good defense by the Hatters. Down low is Chris Zajac. Fouled on the way up. He's going to line for two.
And that's more what the Wreckers need, as they need every point they can get now. But on the prior possession, Klacko just needs to be careful with the ball. As it looks like Rylan Norley is checking into the game, as well as Will Holloman.
Two players
we haven't seen yet at all in this game.
So Staples now in the double bonus. Zajac gets two. He's going to knock down that first one. It's just 4 points now.
You know, I know Rylan Norley is a great defender for the Staples Wreckers, and he's leading the team in steals. So maybe that's what they're looking for from him.
That second one, no good, but Holloman gets the rebound. The Staples has an opportunity here. Udall at the left wing. He holds it. Now Holloman in the corner. Holloman, left corner. Down low to Zajac. Guarded by three. Back up to Holloman in the corner. Holloman making his move. Zajac down low. There it is. The Wreckers are within two.
Holloman, an immediate impact into this game, drawing the defense in and dishing a great pass to Zajac. And now the Wreckers are within two.
Danbury up by two. It's Kashawn Perkins who's trying to waste time now. It's going to be a five-second violation by Danbury. And what a play, because that completely shifts the tide. If the Staples Wreckers are able to score here, they can get the lead or possibly just tie it up at that.
Absolutely, and what a sequence of events for the Wreckers. Although Zajac missed the free throw, Will Holloman with a huge rebound and got them even more points as Udell gets fouled.
And now an opportunity to tie it up. He goes to the line for two shots. And that's Sham Perkins with the foul. ...54-56 is your score. Wreckers down by two with 1:30 to go in the game.
Udell missed a free throw earlier. Hoping to do the opposite here.
A clutch play if he were to knock these down. And that first one is no good off the back of the rim. So at best, with this free throw, they can make it just 1 point. Udell, the sophomore, stepping up into a big role this season. And his second one, a roaring gym. No good. Rebound Wreckers, though. Udell gets it himself. But it's Jeffers who steals it, and it's a foul by Udell.
Udell hitting back iron both of those free throws. He's just a sophomore. Maybe a little bit frustrated here. Definitely a little bit frustrated. Got the rebound. Acrobatic rebound, but the Hatters got to him quick.
Still not in the double bonus. It'll just be an inbound. Wreckers down by two with under 1:30 to go. Going fast down is Shaz Perkins. And he's fouled on the way there. That'll be Holloman. And he goes to the line for 1-1.
Huge free throws here, as they can make it a two-possession game with, if he can hit both of these. But on the other hand, if he misses it, Wreckers have a chance to take the lead.
The Wreckers need this rebound here, and no one better but Chris Zajac to be down there for the Wreckers. Kashawn Perkins, one of two brothers on this team. Cam Perkins is the odd one out.
Tell
not the
what,
brother, just the same last name.
He has come up big in this first half.
That first one is good, and the lead's at 3 points for the Hatters.
Excuse me, second half. And a big free throw there.
Holloman's going to come in for Udell. Udell going back to the bench. A little frustrated, but it's okay. The second shot's going to fall, and the Hatters are up by four. It's a two-possession game.
What huge free throws there from Cusion Perkins, as he has really come on in this second half, making it a two-possession game now.
58-54, the Wreckers down with 1:16 here to go. Holloman taking it up for the Wreckers, driving all the way to the paint, lifting up the layup. No good. Jeffers with the rebound. And he's going to immediately cause a foul. Sale gets charged. And this is all the Wreckers can do. They need to foul and hope that the shot gets missed.
Now all they can really do is hope that the Hatters miss free throws. But a good look there from Holloman. Great take, but just couldn't get it to go, unfortunately for him.
And
he is frustrated.
He has 1-1 here. Jeffers, we saw his strength in the paint. Let's see if he can do it from the free throw line tonight. That first shot is good. Now it's at 5 points. The Wreckers slowly falling out of this game.
Hatters with big free throws. Plush free throws.
And the second one is good. Lead now at 6 points for the Hatters. And Rothenberg gets it. But Smith's looking for the pass, and he throws it straight out of bounds.
Just can't happen there for the Wreckers. Smith just a bit off on that throw as it landed right in front of us, but that's a huge play there as the Wreckers lost a possession.
107 here to go in the game. Wreckers down by six and an inbound here from Kashawn Perkins. Kashawn getting it to Chapman in the left corner. Back out to Chimez up top. It's Clacko with the foul. He's going to the line for 1-1.
Wow, a pretty harsh foul there. Sham Perkins is mad. Clacko, we saw that earlier in the game. He was chirping him, but once again, huge free throws here for Sham.
.104 here to go. His first free throw. No good. Rebound by Cam Perkins, though, and he puts that in for an easy two. Nowhere to be seen with Staples on that one. Going the other way is Udell. Udell on the right corner now. Hands it off to Clacko on the right wing. Open is Sale for three in the left wing. No good. Off the rim. And rebound by the Hatters. 48 seconds to go, and it's Jeffers going the other way. Has an open man in the paint. It's Chapman. He's just going to slow it down, have an easy shot, not going to take it. And he's now... Kashawn Perkins gets fouled at the Danbury logo, and what was almost
smart there from Chapman, as the fans are huge, as the fans are extremely loud now. But wasting a little bit of time there was Chapman, and that was smart. As Perkins, Fusion Perkins with huge free throws once again here. Misses the first.
Now, the second one by Kashawn rattles in. And that makes it 9-point differential as the Wreckers get it to Clacko in the corner. He's going to shoot that one for three off the back iron. Rebound by Cam Perkins. Kashawn now going down the left side. Has an open Chapman in the paint. Just going to hold it. Not going to do anything. He has it in the paint. 20 seconds to go here. Cam Perkins and Staples has all but conceded. As Danbury's going to win. What a thriller.
Wow, what a game that was. But Danbury completely turning the tide in that fourth quarter. Man, did they just fire on all cylinders. Down 10 going into that fourth quarter. Ended up winning by 9 points as it is electric in here right now.
Staples went into this corner up 10 points. And they lose it down by 9. Outscored by 19 points in this quarter. That might be one of the worst they've had of the entire season.
Yeah, and
what a start for the Hatters here. This is Coach Bach's best start in his entire career. They really pulled through with this one. Talk about what they were able to do. Jeffers having an amazing game himself, as well as Perkins, who really had a game. Jeffers had 17 points, Perkins with 14. And not even alone, Cam Perkins also had another 12 of his own. I mean, you saw production from everywhere on the court for Danbury. But on the other side of things, Staples unfortunately just lost their rhythm when it came to crunch time.
They did, and Danbury was the opposite when it came to crunch time. They looked completely at their best in that fourth quarter, and they just completely turned the tide with, like you said, Fusion Perkins and Christian Jeff.